Hi, it's Connecticut car accident attorney Ryan McKean here. Today I'm going to talk to you about something that comes up a lot. Does MetLife have to pay you if you use your vacation time to deal with the aftermath of an accident? Things like going to the doctor, you're in too much pain, or getting your car fixed. I'm not talking about going on a beach. I'm talking about all those things that you use those precious vacation days to make ends meet while you are dealing with the aftermath of a car accident. And you're going to want to watch this one all the way through, because I talk about whether or not you can make a claim against MetLife. I talk about how to do that, what documents that MetLife you're going to need to get to them. I talk about the value from demand all the way through litigation and even into trial, which is greater than the economic loss to you, which is greater than the days used, and how that really impacts your case and how I approach it as a trial lawyer. So watch all the way through, and I hope this helps you fight back against MetLife. Now, this situation comes up a lot where people have jobs and they're unable to work because of an injury, because of a car accident or a fall or some kind of malpractice. And fortunately, they have a good job and they can still get paid from their job to do things like take medical appointments. Maybe they're unable to work because they're in so much pain. Maybe they have to deal with their car, getting their car fixed. You know, when somebody suffers an injury or an accident, there's a whole host of things that somebody didn't plan to do that week. You had planned for a week that was going to go one way. You're going to go to the football practice. You're going to go see your child play soccer. You were going to go see your grandmother, your family. You were going to, run some errands or maybe take the family on a hike. And suddenly you have to do all these things, and you still have your work obligations, right? You still have those deadlines. Maybe you work in an hourly job, and if you don't show up, you don't get paid. Maybe you have flexibility. Maybe you don't. So a lot of times our clients have to use some vacation time to compensate them, because most people in Connecticut live paycheck to paycheck, and they can't afford to go, 1, 2, 3, 4 days without work. So they're using their vacation time. And what could be more precious in this world than vacation time? You know, that's your time to go out and to be with your family, or time to be alone, whether you're going to travel or, go to the beach locally, go to Long Island Sound, go for walks, take a staycation. That time is so valuable and precious, and we don't get enough of it. And so when you have to use it to compensate you for an accident, basically to survive, that is a loss. And so what a lot of clients ask us is, is this a lost wage claim? Because I didn't really lose any wages, right? I was making $1,000 a week. And, the week I was in the accident, I had to take, 2, 3 days off, but I still made $1,000. So at the end of the year, my tax return, it doesn't reflect that I suffered an economic loss. Well, this happens a lot, and it's a really good question. The law is that if you are having to use vacation days from an employer's perspective and from the law's perspective are actually just money. There is a dollar value attached to those days, and employers can give you time, they can give you money, but really time is money. And so when you're having to use those vacation days, that needs to be added to your lost wage claim. And so the question is, how do you prove that? Right? So generally what we would do is write to your boss, your manager, your human resources, if you work at a larger company, and we have a form, and we just say, was this person out during these days? What kind of leave did they take? And then we can show them that, in fact, this person did take leave. We can talk to a doctor and say that the leave was necessary, or we can have you do a statement that says I had to take this time and it was related to the accident. And obviously, the proximity to the accident matters. If it's months later and you're saying I need to fix my car, It may be harder to prove that it's related, but maybe we can show that you were at the body shop that day. So it really becomes an issue of proof, and that's something that if you're in an accident that you should definitely be talking to your lawyer about how to prove, because to me, that is a big, big loss. Like, it's almost like the law can only compensate you for the money part of it, but to lose your vacation days, I'm sorry, nobody wants to vacation at a body shop or a chiropractor's office or a physical therapist or, you know, on their couch because they're in so much pain and can't get off the couch. So I really think it's important if you hire an injury lawyer to really talk to them about this so that they can understand the losses. Now, they should be asking you about it. Our firm would absolutely be asking you about it. And this information should be put into a demand letter with the documentation, should be given to the insurance company. If the insurance company doesn't accept it, you know, you have to make a decision to litigate it. If it needs to be litigated, that information needs to be on the interrogatories. They need to go with discovery and production. And that claim really needs to be made. And I actually think it just really, it does something else beyond the 2 or 3 days. It is a way for a lawyer, a trial lawyer, to highlight the impact on your life because it's reflective. Like, nobody would choose to use their vacation time to lay on a couch in pain or to be in a physical therapist office or an orthopedist office or to not work. Many people, self included, like to go to work. It gives us a reason for being. It brings us community, and it's an important thing for us to go out and add value. It's not what we use vacation time for. So you should make sure that you're compensated for that. You should make sure that your lawyer is doing it. And if you're, you know, representing yourself, you should make that claim to the insurance company because under Connecticut law, they have to pay you for those vacation days. They have to pay you, you know, what is a day's wage? That's how you would calculate it. What, you know, we can look at your tax return. We can divide by 52.3. We can say that, you know, normally you worked 30 hours a week and, you know, the hourly rate is $20 an hour. Whatever the case may be, there's a way to calculate the value of that time. So it's worth doing. It's useful in the event of a mediation or a trial for your lawyer to be able to point to something tangible. This is how much they were willing to pay to get out of this pain. They were willing to use their precious vacation time. Look, United States is not Europe. We don't have 6 weeks off or 8 weeks off. Our time off is very, very precious. And we need to work to make sure the insurance companies value that time. If you have any questions, you know, don't hesitate to give me a call, 860-471-8333.